In this video, revealing a step-by-step tutorial on how to start selling on Amazon and how complete beginners earning $100 to $700 a day with no experience and sometimes without even having their own product. More of that after the intro. Hey guys, how's it going? Mike Vasile here. Welcome to this video. Before we actually begin, I remind you that several spots have opened up for this week's free workshop, where it's the fastest and easiest way to make money online. Sign up for it in the link below. We literally have a 62-year-old woman go from zero to $160,000 profit in 90 days, so sign up now. So I remember when I first heard about selling on Amazon, it just blew my mind, because I was literally a broke college student studying to become a dentist, and here I was just not knowing that literally normal, ordinary people could literally partner with Amazon. They will ship the product, they will sell the product, they'll do the customer service, they'll do all of those things that most people don't want to do when they start a business, except they will also pay you. So they'll do all of that, but you can literally get started for literally pennies on the dollar, right? When I figured that out, I was like, oh my God, man, if I could find a way to make $100 a day, that was like my goal, $100 a day profit, I could go ahead and, for example, help my mom and dad pay off the credit card bills, pay off my student loan debt, start traveling, right? Start experiencing life and more freedom. So I literally dove all in into Amazon, and there were so many different ways that we sold on Amazon, right? Some of these made me $100 a day to even $700 a day at its peak. And some of these made me lose a bunch of money. And this video is what I wish I would have when I first got started, to just understand which one would be the best opportunity for me as someone that did not have any time, not experience in that, not that much upfront capital. So I want to divide this into three ways to make money selling on Amazon. The first one is the obvious way that everyone goes to, but it's also the most competitive, the most riskiest, and takes the longest. And the other two ways are actually free to get started. But like I said, I'm gonna go more about that later on. And it's more interesting because, like I said, you don't have to do certain things that the traditional way does it. So the first way is the traditional way to make money selling on Amazon. This is exactly what I did. I remember, you know, for example, selling things like grill mats, right? I would come in here and I was like, okay, I'm gonna sell these grill mats. And I would literally go to a place like Alibaba.com, which is essentially a marketplace in China that rounds up all of the people that would go ahead and like create these products for you. I would literally come in here, type in grill mat, and I remember like just talking and bartering with them, super old school ways of doing business, man, because some of these prices aren't necessarily the prices. Like, you could barter with them, they might overcharge you, they might undercharge you. It's like the most funny thing. Like, in America, it costs what it costs. Like, the price, that costs what it costs. Here, this is just a suggestion, but I'm open to changing this, right? And you can see exactly some of these grill mats are like $1, you know, 60 cents, 20 cents. And you see these grill mats are going for 19 bucks. So that's like ridiculous profit margins. So when I got started this way, right, what were the steps that I needed to do? Well, step number one, I needed to find a winning product. How did I find a winning product? I would literally just type in, well, what are people searching for on Amazon? And all these things started popping up. So I was like, oh, people want grill mats. And if there's like 2 billion people going on Amazon every single month, you know, probably a good amount are looking for grill mats. So I would just go ahead and remember, like, I would chat now with them and I'd be like, hey, you know, can I get a sample of this thing? And what I made sure I did is, you know, all these people, you know, there's some things that they're doing wrong with their product, right? So I remember coming over here and looking at all of the negative reviews, all of the negative reviews that this thing had. And when I would get a sample, I would make sure that it circumnavigated that. And this product did really well with it. You can see this. Look at this. They literally take their competitors, like Yoshi Grill Mat, 4 times thicker. And then the Miracle Grill Mat, 2 times thicker. So they literally rank for their competitors' keywords, right? And then they have that unique selling point. So if I wanted it to be thicker, I would make sure that, hey, what is the thickest grill mat that you have? Send me a sample. And I would see the quality. Does this feel like a plastic bag, or does this feel like high quality material that I could sell this for 20 bucks, like a pop, right? Like, that's what I needed to start doing. When I did that, the next step that I did is literally ordered it in bulk and had them put my own logo on that actual design. But you're probably going, oh, Mike, I'm not a designer. Well, you could literally go to a place like, for example, Upwork.com, and you could hire a graphic designer to do this for you. I could type in graphic designer, right? And you could get them for like really, really, really cheap. Just make sure that the location filter is in the Philippines, and make sure the hourly rate is $10 an hour or below. And you can see that some of these graphic designers will literally work for you for like $10 an hour, and they have like good job success. You can see this one, $7 an hour, 100% success rate, top rated.
right? So they can literally design something that only takes them a couple hours, and you can literally just send them to your supplier in China, which you talk, like, for example, on here on Skype, and then you just have them put your own grill mat like logo on there, and they ship it to you, right? And then, of course, you would go put it on Amazon. And then what I did in the beginning, like I said, this isn't the sexiest way, and I think this is the most riskiest way. The other ways I'm gonna share with you are a lot easier, especially for beginners, that actually doesn't take much, if anything, no money whatsoever. And literally, the moment I put it up on here, I would have to like beg and borrow, like for example, my cousins and aunts and uncles and my girlfriend and her mom and her dad, to literally buy this product for me and leave a review so I could get 20 reviews. Right, so it was extremely hard, it was extremely difficult, it was extremely annoying because some of my family members would literally buy it and not leave a review, and I'm like, dude, come on, like, don't you love me? Like, you're supposed to support me, right? You're my family. That was like literally the hardest part. And of course, the only downside with this method is you do have to pay $39 a month for this. I did the stupid way. I literally became an Amazon seller, signed up and paid for this, and then I did all this hard stuff with dealing with China. But then I was also paying this $39 every month. To save yourself time and money, do this last, okay? But this is like the hardest way to make money with Amazon. And I know people that made good money with this, but quite frankly, it's because they sold their business. The only downside with this method, before I share with you the easier methods that are far more profitable, is every time you make profit, remember, your revenue is growing, right? So if you're making $5,000 a month, but you're on track to hit 10 grand a month. To sell 10 grand a month worth of material, you need to buy more inventory. So all of your profit from the previous month literally is thrown in to buy more products in China. That's why a lot of people that are even making, like, for example, like when I was like making $700 a day, we weren't profiting that much because we were always buying more inventory to send it over to like Amazon. So it's very, very hard. The people that I interview on my podcast, like for example, this 11-year-old girl that turned on $30 million, and this guy that makes $1 million per month profit, and even other people that made a bunch of money in Amazon, they made most of the money when they sold their business and they got a huge chunk in cash. If you don't have the expectation of wanting to sell your business, Amazon FBA and selling on Amazon and even paying for this $39.99 might not actually be worth it. But you're probably going, well, Mike, what are my options then? How can I sell on Amazon but like not have to go through all those hoops? Well, the next one that I'd actually recommend is selling t-shirts on Amazon. And you're probably, well, what? Like, do I still have to pay $39 a month to go ahead and sell t-shirts? No. Do I still have to ship the products myself? No. Do I have to talk to people from China and order my products and buy any of, like, spending my own money on it? No. Look at this. Did you know, if I type in, for example, here's something similar, dab t-shirt. I saw this the other day and I was like, look at all these t-shirts. They're all the same t-shirts. The crevices are all the same. What does that actually mean? These designs don't actually exist on these t-shirts until someone actually buys it. It's known as print on demand, right? And the craziest thing is if I literally go ahead and buy this Dab Cat t-shirt, right? There is someone that's just like you and I that's selling this t-shirt anywhere in the world. And if someone buys, Amazon will literally for free print this design that doesn't even exist on this t-shirt yet, on this t-shirt that they own, and they ship it to your customers for you with Prime shipping, and you don't have to pay anything. In fact, they just pay you for your designs, right? But you don't even have to create these designs, right? So you're probably wondering, well, how the heck would I go ahead and do this? Well, instead of going to Amazon seller account, you literally go to a secret site known as merch.amazon.com. And you can see exactly how this works. We sell your designs as Amazon products, reaching millions of customers worldwide with no upfront investment or cost to you. You're like, Mike, what's the catch? There is no catch, it's free. You just upload your Upwork, set a list price, we print what's sold, fast shipping with Prime, earn monthly royalties. Does that make sense? Now you're probably wondering, well, Mike, how would I go ahead and get started with this? Well, the first step is understanding what products you wanna rank for. So notice like when I typed in grill mat, all these things pop up for. That's because there's literally a portion of the 2.6 billion people that are searching for this every single day, right? But it's the exact same thing with t-shirts. If I type in cat t-shirt, all these things pop up. I can literally sell products on Amazon without actually having to buy my own inventory. How ridiculous is that? Let's do cat t-shirts for women. You can see all of these things that pop up. All of these things are making sales. Look, it's 1,000 reviews. A lot of these people, look at this. The crevices and the shadows are all in the exact same. What does that mean? It's literally the exact same like t-shirt, and none of these designs actually exist until someone buys this. And people aren't spending any money on their own inventory from China. How amazing that does that sound? So you're probably wondering, well, how would I go ahead and find these designs? Well, all you really got to do is literally go to Pinterest. And what I do is I type in cat t-shirt, and you can see some of these things are very, very easy to create. Like, for example, got to have more cats. You can literally go to canva.com and then click on this thing called t-shirts, right? And you can literally create like a design within seconds. Got to have more cats, or I want more cats. And just like that, I can download this, upload it onto Merch by Amazon, and just like that, like list it on Amazon by the end of today when you're watching this video. Does that make sense? Right, well, what other ways that I can make? Well, the thing that I saw about this opportunity is you wanna think about it like a real estate game. This is what all of my friends that I interview on my podcast that make money with like Amazon FBA and whatnot do really well with, is because all these things, like if you think about each one of these words that people are searching for, these are like addresses, like real estate addresses, right? And in business, how do you make the most money before the internet? You literally get a brick and mortar business and you put it in an address where there's a lot of people and a lot of eyeballs that could see this dentist or this McDonald's or this Starbucks, if that makes sense. That's the exact same thing that's happening on here. So you literally need to think about each one of these on real estate. But the traditional real estate, you'd have to go get a loan from the bank, put tens of thousands of dollars of your own money up front, and find a tenant to go ahead and be in that piece of real estate, and maybe you could cash flow $200. One of these designs can make you $100 to $200 a month, right? Like I remember I was selling like designs in the elephant niche and in the Jesus niche, and some of those designs were even making me $100 a day. $100 a day, guys. So just do worst case scenario. You maybe only make $100 a month for a design, right? Pretty doable, right? If you get 10 designs to make you $100 a month, that's already $1,000 a month profit that you did not have to pay for. You did not even have to create an Amazon seller account for. You didn't even have to buy products from China and deal with Chinese suppliers for. That's the beauty of merchbyamazon.com. So all I gotta do is just rank for all these other things. Like for example, I have a Beagle, right? So Beagle gifts for women. You can see that I can literally put like certain mugs and t-shirts and rank for certain one of these things for Beagles, right? Look at this, there's only some Beagle t-shirts, and you can see some of these designs are already proven, like this rainbow thing, right? Like I've noticed that exact same like product, for example, but like with the cats. Look, a rainbow cat, right? So you can see that these designs are interchangeable between, like for example, different animals and different niches. You're probably wondering, what would do really well with this? Pick products that will tie into someone's identity. Like I'm a cat lover, I'm a jujitsu lover, I'm a health lover, I'm a fitness lover. A really good example, if I type in, for example, dab t-shirt, you could see what are identities that do well. Like for example, the Hispanic niche, right? Like people that love cats is popular. People love pandas is a big thing. I had a girlfriend at the time when I was like in high school, she was Polish, and I came over one day and her mom, or was it grandma, literally had elephants everywhere. Like she was one of those crazy elephant ladies, elephant pillowcases, elephant plush toys, elephant earrings, elephant statues. I was like, why does your like grandma or mom have all these elephant things? She's like, oh, she believes it's good luck, right? So you could see that there's all these different things. Golfers is an identity. Tacos, people that like tacos, multiple tacos. Look at this, 179 reviews. You can even see that there's like football players right here, people that like burgers, unicorns, watermelons. This is pretty funny, a panda. So you can see that like if you play to someone's identity, you can make money with it that way, because you gotta wonder, well, why do people wear these t-shirts? It's because it's based on their identity, right? Now, you could literally go and create it yourself, and you can literally go to Pinterest and find a bunch of winning campaigns. But if you really want to scale it, you would outsource it the moment you start making good money. Like I would go to a place like, for example, Upwork.com, and you could hire people that are graphic designers from the Philippines for $10 an hour below. And you can see someone like this girl right here literally charges $7 an hour, 100,000 or 100% job success, top rated. And I remember what I did is I would literally find a bunch of these things from Pinterest, screenshot a bunch of these because I couldn't make some of these designs. And I would send them over to the my Filipino in the Philippines and be like, hey, can you model this? And they'd be like, yeah. And it averaged me about like $2 a design, especially if it's like very something similar as like this. Like something like this. Cats are cool too. I mean, that happened so fast. I could literally come in here, cats are cool too. I just created a t-shirt, download, go to Merch by Amazon, upload, and then just Already, it's already selling on Amazon. By today, you could get it up and running. Does that make sense? Now, that's another way that people make money with it. That way, in hiring designers to go ahead and do that. And remember, if you just get 10 products to get you $100 a month, that's already $1,000 a month profit that you don't have to buy more inventory to go ahead and make. Does it make sense? Your only game is finding the winning designs where you could literally go to Pinterest and just model what's already working. And we have more print-on-demand tutorials in the links below. The next step is selling on Amazon by doing the exact same thing but with books. Now, I did the personal brand approach where, like, if you, for example, come in here and type in Mike Vasile, you know, I literally like went the whole shebang. I have an audio book, I have a Kindle book, I have a paperback book, and I make passive income from this. But what if you don't want to be a writer? Well, I literally, while traveling, like I said, I interview all these successful people that make a bunch of money online. Like this 11-year-old girl that turned on $30 million, this guy that makes $1 million per month profit, right? And while traveling, I was in Thailand and I met this guy who was literally jacked Scottish guy. And I'm like, what do you do to make money? And he's like, mate, I sell books about werewolf love stories. I was like, what? You're a writer? He's like, no, mate, I've never written a book in my life. I get other people to do it for me. And I'm like, what? So this example of what he does, if I type in werewolf love, notice all these things that pop up. These are what people are literally searching for, right? So what he would do is he would rank for like these books right here, and he would make money by literally selling like these werewolf love story books, as weird as it is. Like if I just type in, for example, werewolf love, like I said, all these things that pop up, these are literally what he would like rank for, all these different things, right? And the most interesting about it is, look at this, the reviews, there's far less reviews, right? And if I literally click on any one of these books, you can see that some of these books, like, yeah, this one's 166 pages, but like, I remember like looking at some of these books, like some of these books are only like 50 pages, right? Like, look at this, 179 pages. Let's look for one that's even like less reviews. Like, look, this one's only 77 pages, right? And this one has so many different categories of like, look, 1, 2, 3. Like, these people got a bunch of books of literally the exact same thing. Academy of the Beasts, Shifter Romance, right? That's literally like his niche. He was like, yeah, mate, I'm in the Shifter Romance niche. Right? And I was like, what? And he did the exact same thing. He would literally go, same way like with print on demand, but he would type in freelance writer. He would then go to Amazon and buy all of the top, you know, werewolf love story books. And he would literally give them to some of these freelance writers in the Philippines and have them read it. Like this girl right here, only $4 an hour. Like, hey, read these books. I want to write something similar like this. And they would just model it, same way like how you would model something like on Pinterest, right? And then he would literally just go to kdp.amazon.com, upload it for free, reaching millions of readers on Amazon. And you could see that you can literally do this for anything. Like, for example, if I type in, this is Shifter Romance, Shifter Romance. Look at this, Shifter Romance audiobooks, Shifter Romance box set, Shifter Romance BWWM, right? So there's all these interesting, what is this, like black women, white man, right? Like, so look at this, six reviews. Look at this. Now let's see, like in all these three pages, there's 206 pages and whatnot. But what else do we got in here? We got like it's so interesting how people are making money with this one. Let's check out this one. Seduced by White Alpha. 67 pages, right? So it's like you could sell anything on Amazon, really. And he makes six figures a year doing this. So I just literally gave you guys the keys to the kingdom. Guys, there's even better ways to make money that's even far more easier than this, where you don't have to sell to people that are into like these interesting niches. That is a lot faster than you might think. We literally have people go from $10 a day to $100 a day to $1,000 a day with no experience, with no tech skills, and without actually having their own product. And we're revealing it this week, that's brand new this year, in this week's free workshop, where we have a 62-year-old woman go from zero to $160,000 in 90 days. Find out more in this week's free workshop below, as well as check out my podcast of all these really successful people that live here in Bali that make a bunch of money online. Like this 11-year-old girl that turned on $30 million, and this guy makes $1 million from profit. Check it out right here. Hope yourselves, love you guys, see you guys later. Woo!